Hello and welcome to a new video presented by Telescope Service. My name is Thorsten and in this video I want to show you some insights of the TS Optics UNC and ONTC series of Newtonian telescopes. So there are two series. We start with the UNC series. These telescopes are the entry in customized telescopes. It works in a way that we choose stock components. We select proper mirrors, we put the mirrors into a carbon tube, a German manufactured carbon tube, and equip the telescope also with a high quality focuser. A TS Optics monorail focuser is used for the UNC series. So these telescopes are produced on stock. That means we can ensure a fast shipping rate for these telescopes and they are of high quality. You can also expect very nice results with these telescopes. They are available from 6-inch diameter with a focal ratio of f4 up to a diameter of 12-inch. Now, if you want to have something completely customized and of the best quality that is possible, then we can suggest you the ONTC series. This series of telescopes is completely designed and built here in Germany in our workshop, and we use very specific components for these telescopes. That means we select high quality mirrors from different manufacturers. For example, since beginning of the year, also from the company AstroReflect, where we can ensure a very high quality of the mirrors. We put the components also in a carbon tube that you can see here. We equip it with a focuser of your choice. We document all the steps of the processing of the building of these telescopes. We check it on the optical bench that you get the perfect telescope for your needs. As an example for an ONTC telescope, I have here an 8-inch f4. As said, just an example, they are also available starting with 6-inch f4 up to the mighty 16-inch telescope. So now let's go through some of the parts of this telescope. When we ship the telescope, there. Front and the back is of course covered with this canvas here to ensure that no dust gets in the tube itself. So the first thing that you will recognize is this wonderful carbon tube here. It is of very nice quality. It is a solid one, I think, so no sandwich construction. It's okay for the size. It's not super lightweight, but it should be as rigid as possible. So with the carbon tube, you don't have issues with temperature change. So this is already the best choice you can do for a Newtonian scope. It is delivered with ring clamps, aluminum machined ring clamps here, but without a dovetail. You have to choose the dovetail from the shop according to your mount. So may it be a Vixen GP level or a Los Mandi style dovetail, you should just put this into the basket when ordering the telescope. The ring clamps are also equipped with additional threads here, I think M6, where you can attach additional equipment if you want, maybe a second scope or whatever, ASI Air. You can connect these things here on the top. Let's check out the most important part, which are the mirrors. So I don't want to disassemble the telescope, but I can show you some details. Okay, here we have the back of the primary mirror cell, and this mirror cell is specifically designed for the ONTC telescope series. So it is an open construction that helps to let the air flow through the tube that the mirror cools down more quickly. For collimation, you have these big knurled screws here. They are spring-loaded and will adjust the tilt of the primary mirror. These small screws here are intended to lock the collimation. So you can do the collimation without any tools. So no fiddling around with wrenches in the darkness. Only for tightening, for locking the collimation, here you need one Allen wrench. So as said, 9-point support here for the primary mirror. Pretty simple, but very rigid, stable, and easy design. I really like this one. There is a little disadvantage of this open tube, which can be stray light, which hits the tube from the back if you point it to the horizon, or also dew. But the tube, you can see, I think you can see, the tube is longer than needed, roughly 10 centimeters longer than really needed. That will help to block the dew out of the tube and also stray light. The mirror is just protected from getting hitting by stray light. And here you can also see another feature of the tube or of the ONTC design, which are these multiple holes here. So currently the primary mirror is mounted in the middle position, but you can choose if you want to use it for a different setup. If you want to use it visual or with a different corrector, you can put the primary also into a different position here, just by loosening these nuts and moving the cell into a different position. This is pretty straightforward, so you don't have to need to use extension tubes in your focuser. Pretty easy job to set it up for a different configuration. And now the last look back in the tube. What I want to mention is this velour coating here, some sort of very dark and anti-reflective canvas that will help to block all reflections. And when talking about mirrors, we have a look at the secondary here in the front. Also specifically designed a mirror holder for the secondary here. Pretty straightforward. And also nice feature here, knurled knobs for the collimation. That means you can also adjust your secondary without wrenches, which is always good, because when handling tools here in the front of a Newtonian telescope, there's always the danger that they may fall into the tube and hit the primary. So no issue here, it's just doable by hand. Regarding collimation, if you don't know what collimation of Newtonians is, I will put a card on the top here so you can follow steps for Newtonian collimation if you want. And by the way, for a collimation of such a high-class telescope, and this is what we're talking about, I would always recommend also a very good laser. Definitely a laser that is either self-centering or which you can collimate. That means that you can ensure that the laser will not introduce any problems. For example, such a 2-inch laser does a great job, or also a bar load laser would be a good option for such a telescope. Okay, last but not least, the focuser. As mentioned, with an ONTC telescope, you can choose your focuser. Maybe you prefer rack and pinion over Crayford or vice versa. It's up to you to decide, depending on your desired use of the telescope. May it be for visual observing, then maybe a Crayford is far enough, or you want to attach a heavy camera, then a rack and pinion may be more sufficient. Here in this example, a TS Optics monorail focuser is mounted. This is a 3-inch version because this is definitely designed for astrophotography. So when ordering this telescope in the standard configuration, it's already equipped with a coma corrector, which is this NAG coma corrector, a 3-inch version with an M68 thread here on the top, which is achieved by an adaption ring. M68 and this coma corrector can illuminate also full-frame cameras. That's an exceptional corrector, working very well. One remark on that corrector, it will extend the focal length by a factor of 1.15, something like that. So this 800 millimeter focal length will then extend to 930 millimeter focal length. And focal ratio f4.5 something. About these ONTC telescopes, there are many stories to tell because they are available on the market now for a couple of years and customers really like it. I will show you some of our customers' images in the end of the video. That's all what I want to tell you about the ONTC and UNC series. I hope you liked the video. I hope it was informative for you. If you have any questions, feel free to drop a comment below the video. So thank you very much for viewing, and see you next time. Bye bye.